And you ought to be so free that you can engage in spiritual exploration with geniuses like Herbie Hancock, Buddhist. Giant like bell hooks, Buddhist. So in that sense, I hear what you're saying. If we're going to be free, we ought to be open to a variety of the forms of spiritual exploration in a variety of religious traditions, including secular traditions too. So that when I say include, I mean that in secularity, there are forms of spirituality. You might not call them religious, but they're forms of spirituality that are still worth taking very, very seriously. So you still have to be true to yourself. I mean, in the end, I still go with Jesus because I have to choose for myself in the face of my own particular way of living and my own particular way of dying and my own way of learning how to die while I live in order to be more decent and compassionate. But that's an individual choice, you know what I mean? And that's fine because you're not choosing for the whole. Like falling in love when you wonder what everybody else thinks. I don't give a damn what they think. This is for me. You know what I mean? And yet you can listen to what others say because they might have some insight. You know? You can listen, but you know, you don't ask for their permission. You don't ask for your mama's permission. courage is the enabling virtue. You don't have the other virtues if you don't have courage and faith. If you have a Christian talk about faith and hope and love, it takes courage to have faith. It takes courage to love. It takes courage to hope. But you can't be a coward. You can't be complacent. You know what I mean? You can't be indifferent. Now, of course, nobody's a full Christian. We're all in the process of becoming because we all fall short. And saying that nobody's fully human because we're all in the process of becoming human over time. Even the Darwinian brothers and sisters would agree with that. But what that means is courage becomes central, you see. Right. See, so it's enabling. The question then is, what is it enabling, you see? Is it enabling a love for everybody, a love for just your tribe, a love for just your neighborhood, a love for just your whatever, you see what I mean? Is it just about justice for your group? Is it just about happiness for your group and so forth? But the courage is crucial. It really is. And that's what I love again about music, though, man, because I can't conceive of a great musician who has not explored the highest levels of courageous engagement in their craft. At the level of form and content, at the level of style and substance. You know, that's what greatness is. It's a courage to go to the edge of life's abyss, to step out on nothing and still think you're gonna land on something. We'll be right back.
Bora Bora.